Hi, I'm Sabrina. Thanks for watching this introductory video on Anatella. Let's start with a really simple example. We will create a data transformation that reads a CSV or text file and copy it into another text file. To create a new data transformation, I click here. I drag and drop into this new window this icon that allows me to read the content of a text file. To configure this little box, I double click it. I want to read the text file census income. This text file is inside the archive named censusincome.raw. Please note that Anatella is able to read natively compressed files. You never need to decompress your data files when working with Anatella. This is really handy because, for example, a really cumbersome 10 GB text file waits after compression, usually less than 500 MB, that is a lot more manageable. This enables Anatella to work with really large datasets on small common hardware. Anatella is the only ETL able to read natively compressed RAR files. Okay, let's already execute this really simple data transformation just to check if everything is fine. First, I will quickly save my data transformation. All data transformation made with Anatella are saved as files with extension .anatella. Some of you might have noticed that the file name of my text file just changed. It's a lot shorter and it now starts with a colon. That's normal and it's actually a nice Anatella feature. If the data files that you are manipulating are located inside the same directory as your .anatella file, then Anatella is storing the file path to these data files in a relative way. Thus, the file path :data/censusincome.raw means that the census income database is located in the subdirectory data relatively to the directory containing my Anatella data transformation script tutorial.anatella. This functionality is interesting when you want to share with your colleagues your Anatella graphs. Because you never know in which root directory your colleague will copy your script and your data, and everything should still work properly whatever the root directory is. This feature allows easy collaboration between several data miners working together on the same project. To execute a graph, I need to switch to run mode. In Anatella, there are two operating modes, connect mode and run mode. This is important. If there is only one thing that you should remember from this video, is that there are two operating modes in Anatella. Connect mode and run mode. In connect mode, you can connect together the little boxes. In run mode, you can run your data transformation. To switch between the two modes, you can either click the two buttons in the toolbar here, or you can click the middle button of your mouse at any time. Let's switch to run mode and execute this little box that reads my text file. To execute the box, click on the output pin of the box. The output pin of the box are the small blue dots on the right side of the box. When you click a pin, you get a full preview of the table that goes out of the pin just here, in the data viewer. So I click the pin. As you can see, Anatella instantaneously starts reading the whole census income database and displays it progressively in the data viewer. One really nice and unique feature of Anatella is that, as soon as there are some rows of the output table that are ready to be shown, Anatella directly and instantaneously shows them to you. In opposition to some other tools, you don't need to wait for the complete computation of the whole output table to get a data preview of the first rows. This is really handy when you are developing a new data transformation because it allows you to instantaneously check if your parameters are right. There are about 200,000 rows in this database. With Anatella, you also get a full data preview of these 200,000 rows here, in real time. This is also in opposition to other ETLs. With Anatella, you can always get a full data preview, including all the rows of the output table. The possibility to view the full output table, even if it's a 1 TB table, is unique and it's really handy. Everything seems okay. Let's continue. I drag and drop this other little box. This box writes into a text file. Now I need to connect the two little boxes. To connect the little boxes together, I switch to connect mode. Then I simply click the two pins, the two blue dots. Once again, to configure this little box, I just double-click it. Please note that the box that writes text file is now with a green border. The green border indicates which box is currently being edited. Okay, to run this script, I have now three options. The first option is to right-click the box and then click the play icon. This will execute the data transformation up to this point. The second option is to click the output pin as we just did at the very beginning of this video. These two options are nice, but each time I want to run this script, I need to remember that this is precisely this little box that I need to execute to run my script. Remembering that can be annoying when I have a very complex data transformation, with many little boxes and you don't remember exactly which one you need to run. This is why there's a third option. Everything that is connected to the finish line flag box will run when I click the Run to Finish Line button in the toolbar. You can think of the Finish Line flag as a tag that says I need to run the data transformation up to this point. You can also document your data transformations directly inside a graph. The ability to document each step of your data transformation is critical when you have to maintain or reuse your transformations. This concludes our first video introduction to Anatella. You are now able to develop any data transformation script with Anatella. I now invite you to watch a second introductory video to Anatella that presents important features that will increase substantially your efficiency when using Anatella. Thanks for watching. Bye.